Hey everybody, I'm Hope Yoder.
Alex Anderson.
And we have something fun for you. So we're here in Tulsa at Be So In, and Alex makes the most beautiful quilts. Let me put one on the screen right now.
Well,
that quilt is beautiful. And so what I'm gonna show you in this video is I'm gonna use CraftNCut and I'm gonna hack Alex Anderson. Woo! And we're gonna make something really fun and unusual and much quicker than our beautiful quilt. So stay tuned. Anything you want to say?
Am I allowed to hack you?
Hack me up.
Oh, well, that came out wrong.
I'm going to totally hack her with CraftNCut, so stay tuned.
Hi, everybody. It's Hope from HopeYoder.com, and I have a fun exercise in CraftNCut using the Auto Artwork Wizard. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to take an image from a website, and we're on quilterselect.com, and there's my friend Miss Alex Anderson, and she's generously donated some free quilt projects. So you will click here. Let me scroll out, and as I go down, we're going to click on the Strawberry Delight pattern. And here's a PDF file that she's generously donated for you to print and make this lovely quilt. Well, I want to take this ice cream design and hack it, if you will, or we're going to do something different with it. So the first thing that we're going to do is screen capture this ice cream cone. And so however you do that on your computer, whether you use the snipping tool or you save to your downloads, we're going to save that image off the internet. Next, we're going to come into the Auto Artwork Wizard, select image, and let's find that screen capture by just scrolling wherever it saves it. I'm going to select this, select next, and what happens with the Auto Artwork Wizard, it's a way that you can take a design off the internet that's a poor resolution image and change it into a vector file so you can create something clever in CraftNCut. I'm going to select next, and you can see I've got three colors here. Look at this image now. It's really grainy and pixelated and not a smooth line, and a smooth line is what cuts well on your digital cutters. So watch what happens next. It goes from fuzzy, pixelated to a vector image, and then we select finish and we have this image that we can use. In our layers window, we're going to open this up. And I only want the ice cream. I don't want the rest. So I change it to the ice cream to a different color, and then I can select everything else, right click, and then delete. Right click and break apart. Now when this happens, let's expand our layers. You can see we have the ice cream, and then we have the cone, and then we have this full object, which we don't need. So we're going to delete that. Now let's work with the cone first. So I'm going to hide the ice cream. The first thing that I want to do is make that line at the top straight. To do that, select the shape tool, and I'm going to select all of these nodes, right click, and delete the points. I don't need that last little point, so I can delete that. Perfect. Now I've got a nice cone, and I don't want this top portion to be part of the cone. That's going to add some bulk. So let's take this and let's remove the top line. We don't want stitching underneath stitching. So to do that, I'll go back to my shape tool, hover your mouse over the node, right click, and left click on split line. We'll do that to both here, split line, and over here you can see that it's split the bottom part of the cone with the top. So I'm going to delete that. Now let's unfill this so you can see it better. When I select off, now you can see I've removed that line, which is exactly what I want. So when I go now to create the blanket stitch, you saw how it worked perfectly before, but check out what happens. Notice the blanket stitches are going the wrong way. They're going away from the fabric, and that's not good. So here's how you would correct this. I'm going to change it into a run stitch. change it into a run stitch, and now flip it horizontally and come back to, a blanket stitch, and now they're going the right way. So I've got to give a shout out to Mark Getz for showing me that while we were at a Rusty Barn show. That's a great tip, and I wanted to share it with you. So now I've got my applique piece for the bottom, and we've got this top that's going to go over with a fluffy ice cream. And notice how the stitching just goes a little bit up into there, but it's going to be hidden. Travel over to your applique, and I'm going to select it as a blanket stitch, and that happens perfectly. All right, so we have our blanket stitch, and what we're going to do with this is the first thing we'll do is we'll go under File, Save As, and you're going to save it as a WAF file in case you need to edit those stitches. And then you'll choose File, Save As, and now you're going to select your embroidery format. Now, one last step is we need to create the applique cut files to cut on our digital cutter. You're going to select all items in the Layers window, Cut Preview, and let's hide this. And here we have the design, and there's no way to cut this file because it doesn't have a top. But check this out. I want to show you, let me zoom out here a little bit. This is one of the previous updates, and you've got these shortcuts, and this is going to close the shape. So if you look right now, there's no line going across. Select it, select close shape, and now you've got a closed shape that will cut. So we'll fill this in with color. We'll change it to an ice cream waffle cone look. And here we have our, strawberry ice cream or tutti frutti or whatever you want. And so I'm going to take these two close together. And the next thing I'm going to do is select all items. I'm going to come to Save to Cut, and you're going to run your design through Save to Cut. This is what's going to generate the two cut files for the ice cream top and bottom, and it's going to give you all the cut settings. So we'll activate that. I'm going to be cutting my sample out on a Brother Scan and Cut batik fabric with applestick. Applestick is a fusible webbing that you're going to place on the back of your appliques. Select next, and here's the magic. This gives you the cut settings, the blade, the mat, all the information for your Scan and Cut. It also tells you how to apply it on the mat. There's a video. Watch that. And copy and paste the USB stick from your desktop to your Scan and Cut, and you're good to go.